Hello, friends. Welcome back to TerraFirmaCraft with your host, Mr. RongoTheBold. I am out exploring, and I just came across this really cool lapis formation, including that whole, floating island of lapis, which is really cool. But what's that? Is this? Wow. More copper. But this is cool. We have exposed rich copper and lapis. So, exposed rich copper and lapis. And we, just so you guys know where we are. We are here. Home is there. So it's not that far away. I've been doing a lot of wandering back and forth. You know what I haven't seen in a while? A bear. I wish you could get pheasants and do something with them. Besides just kill them. Ooh. Quick, quick. We got that. It looks like, I'm going to guess that's tetrahedrite. But it could be. Yep, tetrahedrite. More copper. Sigh. I bet you would never see someone be tired of finding more of core ores. But I've just got so much. It's just ridicule copper. Ridicule! Alright, anyway, I am just exploring. I'm going to go for a little while longer. I'm hitting the coastline here. So I'm basically just going to follow this up. It looks like I'm probably going to be right there, unless it goes like that. It looks like it's going to be a straight line shot to the north. So not going to be as long as I thought it might be for my adventure time. But it is good to check these anyway. We have found a few new crops. I think we found barley. Found some bushes. We found onions. Barley and rice. So not, not terrible bad, but not terrible great either. I'd hope to find some more soybeans. Because again, I swear I had soybean seeds. But I don't know if you do lose things if you die, if you don't get everything back with the open graves or not. Maybe that's what happens. I don't know. Anyway, I will see you guys when I find something cool or in the morning. I found some more malachite and lapis together. And a lot more rice. I seem to be getting a ton of rice in this area. So, more dacite. A little dacite. Ooh, and some gneiss. So where is the gneiss rock? Why one little piece of it? That's kind of odd. Yeah, that's very strange to have one little piece of gneiss pop up. It's kind of cool looking though. This is all marble. Should I try and climb it? Should I try and climb it? See how high I can get? Maybe the view will be awesome. I'm gonna fall to my death. Making more backward progress and upward progress here. Look at that tree on the side of the hill like that. That's pretty cool. Yay, we made it up. Ooh. Okay, so here's where we are. Right there. And it appears to be another, either it's an island. Whoa, that's a fur piece down. Oop, and a crop. I see a crop. Garlic! Yay! We have garlic. A garlic seed. Can't have salsa without garlic, right? We got corn to make corn chips. We've got onions and peppers and tomatoes. And now we've got garlic. Now we use an avocado tree and life will be excellent. All right, I'm gonna search around for some more garlic. And I think I'm gonna go over to that little island and see what is there. This island looks like it's fairly connected, actually. Or it's close to being connected. This little island chain here. You know, I know there's nothing but squid in the water, but I always think I'm gonna get eaten by a something. Oh! Granite! Granite! Something new! Well, that's very cool. It's not, I mean, it's a wee bit away from the house, but it's new. So here's where we are, right there. The house. So this all looks like this is just like right there. It's all, you can almost see the edge of the water right there. So this is all water. I don't know here, and I don't know up farther up that way what's going on. I do know these connect. Oh, you're not a zombie. Don't worry. Dandelions. I've been collecting some flowers. I know I shouldn't use my sword for this. Okay, this market is granite. I'll find some exposed rock, and I'll bring back a stack of this as well. Pick that apart, I think. I don't know. This is a little, it's a little busy. If it means anything. Actually, what I should do is just pick up rocks as I go rather than deal with these guys. We'll grab one full piece. Just so we have a full piece as well. And we can get a better look at it. I grabbed some sand. Because I need some sand, I think, for reasons. For making jars. All right, I'm gonna explore this a bit more. I think for maybe another like 15 minutes or so of game time, maybe, and then we'll come back. We'll head back to the house. I'll probably just. Ooh, it's kind of cool. Yeah. So anyway, I will see you guys if I see. I'll bring you back something cool. Bye. Got something? What are you? Carrot. I found. What else did I find? Whoa. Whoa. Where are you? Oh, great, it's raining. What else did I find? I found a thing. I just found a thing. Carrot. Raspberries. I found raspberries. And I found native silk. Wait, when did I find that? I just picked that up. I think I was hitting rock. So that's where did I find that? That's a thing. Hello, bear. Fuck off, bear. Yes, where did I find? Where did I find that? Well, fucking bear! Fucking bear. It scared the frick out of me. I was just running along around this shoreline. There it is! Cool. That is awesome. I've never found silver before. Silver surface. So, silver is used in some alloys. Let me think what alloys it's used in. I think it's like a sterling silver, which is then used to make blue steel. So, I also found cassiterite over here. So, we do have cassiterite, which I was trying to find earlier when I was actually trying to find sphalerite. But not sphalerite. What was it? Yeah, sphalerite. So that's cool. So now we've got guaranteed all the parts that we need. Wow, there's a lot of it too. Let's actually go ahead and grab it. That's a lot of native silver. So that means there should be a pretty good size deposit somewhere here. I really should have brought my pro pick. Really should have brought my pro pick. Anytime you go on adventures, bring a pro pick or two. Man, that's cool. That's very cool. So, and that's again not really that far from. There's home. There's us. So that's not that far. We're at 12, and that's at 2. So it's 1,400 blocks distance. Cool. All right. So what was I starting to say? I was starting to say something. Surface silver, found a thing, found... Oh, freaking Mr. Bear, you're fast. Oh yeah, now you want to run away, huh? Oh shit. Don't die now, don't die now, don't die now. I almost freaking backed into that. That would have been the end of don't die now. I found gold. Yes, I found gold. I need to... Yes, there's the gold. Gold, silver, cassiterite. This has been a good little area. What else? Oop, is that a thing? Yeah, see, maze. We don't need it, but I'll grab it. It's super hard to see that. Is there any more of it? Yep. It's like super hard to see. What are you? You're amazing as well. So we got a bunch more maize seeds, which is good because I can use it for the cattle. And I don't think I can make bread with it though. And I found wheat, barley, rice, garlic, tomatoes. Pretty good haul of seeds. A couple that I didn't have. So that was kind of the goal of this whole expedition. Was to add to our... What are you? Maybe. Was to add to our collection. So far, so good. All right, guys. I'm gonna head home. What the hell is... Oh. Like, what the hell is that? Oh, it's a bunch of horses together. More maize. More maize? Damn. Yeah, that's... That's super hard to see. All right. I'll show it a few more minutes here, and then I'm heading home before I get killed. Up to level 31. So that part is good. I'm thinking that's, yeah, tomatoes. Tomatoes. It's okay. We can use more seeds, right? And that's a cassiterite. Cassiterite. All right, I'll mark that. So that's basically tin. So that and brass, or that and copper make bronze. All right, guys, I will see you back at the house. It is time to head there. We have been adventuring for a long time. Oh shit. Fuck you, Mr. Bear. Ooh, and I see one more thing. No, I don't. I thought I saw one more thing, but I saw those. All right, see the house. Bye. All right. One last thing before I go home. Look at this view. Look at this freaking view. And I would be willing to bet that's needed gold. And that's also a crop. So now to get down safely. Was a nice, did he come up this side, right? Yeah. Just don't go down too fast. Oh, yeah, more squash. I found a bunch of squash. Oh, thank you for the rain letting up. Nice little canyon here. What's that? Wait, where was I? Like, where was it? I could see it. It's got to be gold, right? Yep, exposed native gold. That's pretty cool. So now we've got very easy access to a lot of gold. I love that big huge arch too. That's really cool. Now I need to get back over on the other side of this little hill, collect those seeds, and then honestly, I will be going home. All right. All right, I don't know what the hell just happened there. My recording is being really odd. Anyway, I am back home. I planted the crops, and the soybeans are not soybeans, they're sugar canes, popped out of the ground because it was too cold. So I'm gonna replant them again. No, still too cold. How is too cold? It's six right now. So it's, yeah, it's colder than I thought. It was warmer for a few days. So we'll see if it continues to be cold. None of the other crops are popping, so I think most of them are okay down to 3 degrees, but sugarcane must be really fickle. So yeah, look at all the crops. It's just freaking amazing. Now, because of I don't know what happened with my recording. I have no clue how long we are right now. So I'm gonna have to just figure it out. And it might be a short episode, it might be a long episode, but my recording got really freaking messed up. I want to show you guys the animals. So the little piggies are still little piggies. They take, I'm not sure how long they take to grow up, but they're still little piggies. The cows should be giving birth in, like, it is 8th of April, so they should be giving birth in like 6 days, 5, 6 days. Then we're gonna have baby cows. Let's see what else. Oh, the chickens. I grabbed some eggs out of the boxes. And the chickens are growing up. You can see there's a couple different generations of chickens in here. And that's a lot of chickens. And I grabbed like three eggs. Ooh, okay. Yeah, food is starting to be starting to be bad. And I decided, let me go ahead and grab, let's get all these guys on the hot bar. Okay. So snowberries, bunchberry, winterberry, raspberry, gooseberry, elderberry, blueberry. What? No snowberry? Winter, bunch. Huh. I could have swore we had snowberry. Maybe not. Oops. Okay. Bunchberry. We have bunchberry here. Okay. And elderberry. Now, I've never done it, but I think we can make gooseberry, elderberry. I think we can make jam. Goose. Duck goose. And raspberry. Cool. Nice little fields of those. And I think when I'm done, so I had an idea, an epiphany, and I don't think I shared it with you guys yet. So the original intent again was to put the house here. But I was just looking when I got back that this is, even if I put it back here or even over here, the view is really kind of meh. But then I realized that I could put it right over here, which would be much prettier. I could set it up so it was kind of like really close to the edge up here. So the design I'm going to go for is kind of an L from this direction. So the front of the house will be a long direction. And I want a porch on the front with like an awning, or, you know, kind of a lattice awning, veranda, cover. And then the big, there'll be a long L back this way. I'm going to go with a one-story house. I debated that. It might have an attic in it, but it's basically going to be a one-story house. I don't need to have a huge sprawling mansion or anything. And then in the back of the house, in the veranda area, I'll have like I want to put a hot tub in, and just put an outdoor, you know, nice little outdoor area. And then we'll have bridges going across here and across there. And I want the fruit trees to come up here when we're all said and done. So we'll have lots of fruit trees going. So I've got green apples. We know where a banana tree is now. My orange tree is doing okay. When does it do? Late autumn, okay. Late autumn. Yeah, I think everything is autumn, basically. That's early summer, though. Cherries, okay. And, yeah. And we are in spring, so we're not in late spring. So we're two more months before that happens. And we can also fix that. So I'm going to be working on my next project again is the barn itself. And the way it's going to work is it's going to be, let's look back here from here. So I'm going to extend it out a little bit on the sides, but then it's going to be kind of three high at the wall edge. And then it's going to kind of go slope and then up and then like that. So because Minecraft doesn't have a ramp block or any kind of slope block, I'm just going to use some stairs and then blocks. So I'm just gonna kind of wing it for that. Do I have any potato? I got a little bit of this left. Oof, really a little bit of that left. All right, so anyway, for now it's been Rongo. Freaking bowls. They almost always break with a salad. I mean, every once in a while I'll get one that doesn't break, but it's pretty much they always break. Anyway, for now it's been RongoTheBold. I hope you guys are enjoying TerraFirmaCraft, my builds. If you are, click the like button. Let me know your thought of my thoughts on putting the house over there. Pretty much probably gonna do it, but I want to hear what you guys think anyway. I think it will have a better, much better view. Okay, what temperature is now? 16. All right, let's try planting those sugar cane again. Anyway, for now, like I said, Rongo, later. Have a great day, and I will talk to you in the next episode of Terra Firma. Crap. Nope. Huh. Huh. Because the wiki doesn't. Yeah, the wiki does not talk about sugar canes. So what the. You can't plant them up here. I'm gonna have to do a little research. Maybe actually plant it on sand or something? All right, anyway, I'll talk to you later. Bye!